Hello, at this stage, we have a model. We have collected data, we have made some behavioral assumptions, we have specified the model, estimated its parameters, we have tested the model, and now we are ready to use the model. We will use it to forecast the future market shares of electric cars. Let's first look at the present situation. So our model is able to predict for each age category the market penetration of electric cars in the population. So as of today, there are 36% of the population who is in the first age category, and they represent a market penetration of 7.2%. And we have the same values for the other age categories. As we saw before, we can easily calculate the current market penetration over the entire population. In this case, it's equal to 5%. Now, if we want to look into the future, well, we need to look at a future scenario. For example, we can talk to experts in demography who will tell us how the age structure of the population will change in the future. For example, they will tell us that in 5 years from now, 25% of the population will be between 20 and 39, 50% will be between 40 and 64, and 25% will be 65 and above. So from this number, knowing the market penetration per age category, which is given by the model, we can actually predict the future share of electric cars in the population by doing the exact same calculation that for the current scenario. We have 25% times 7.2%, 50% times 5%, and 25% times 1%. And altogether, we get a future market shares for the electric car, which is 4.55%. Of course, you can play with as many scenarios as you want. You can calculate the market shares for different types of scenario and investigate how the market shares will change in the future. When we do forecasting, we assume that something does not change. In this context, we assume that the causal relationship between the variables, age and ownership of an electric car, does not vary over time. This causal relationship is captured by the model specification, including the value of its parameters. This does not vary over time. But of course, the values of the explanatory variables, like age in this case, vary over time. And because we have this causal relationship which is stable, we can predict the future values of the explained variable, of the dependent variable, using the model as we did in this example. This example is, of course, very simplistic. It cannot really be applied for concrete applications. But it contains all the ingredients that are necessary for modeling choices in practice. Now, in the rest of the course, we will apply the same ideas. We will investigate the same ingredients, but on realistic data, real data actually, and realistic models.